In this video, we're going to do some very cool things using Excel macros and ChatGPT. I will make a separate video for hardcore Google Sheets users that does the same exact thing. But to be honest with you, you could use this video as a reference to do the same thing in Google Sheets too. So let's first of all assume that there are some steps that we need done with this data. So first of all, let me just make a copy of this spreadsheet just to have a backup. So I'm just going to save this as a different file so we have a copy. Okay, so now that we have this copy, let's go ahead and create a macro that does some steps. Now, what we're going to do, we're going to go to this developer menu and we're going to record a macro. Now, if you don't have developer menu activated in your Excel, you will need to activate it first. And you're going to do that by going to File and go to Options. And under Options, if you go to Customize Ribbon right here, you'll see on the right side, there's this developer checkbox. If it's unchecked, you're going to have to check it. And once you do that, you'll see developer tab. So once I have developer tab, now I can create macros. So I'm going to create macros that does certain things in a spreadsheet. So for example, I have this names column. And let's say I'm going to need to separate first names here and last names here, create column names, get rid of this original column, possibly add some borders to this data, something like that. So I'm going to go to this record macro and we're going to give this a name, macro one for me. That's good enough for now. I'm going to do this workbook to store it in. That's fine too. I'm going to press okay. And now it's recording this macro. So I'm going to create those steps. So first let's try to get first names out of this. So for this, I'm going to go with a function called text before, and this function is going to accept some text, which is going to be this comma. And then we have a delimiter and that's going to be a space. So I'm going to do a space in single quotes, close parentheses, hit enter. And that should give us text before the space, which is our first names. That's our first name, so I'll go ahead and just copy this formula down, double click, and that does this for the whole column. Then I'm going to go here and I'll get the last name, and for this I'm going to use text after function, and for this function I'm going to point to this text, comma, and then our delimiter is going to be a space. Now by default, what this is going to do, if I just close parentheses and press enter, it's going to give us whatever's after our first space, but that's not what I want. I want everything after the last space here. So for that, I'll do a comma and use this instance number. And for that, I'll do negative one to get to the last space. Close parentheses, hit enter, and that gives us this. So I'm going to double click this. That will give us our last names. Then I'll just name this column first name, and this column last name, and then maybe just highlight this, double click to automatically fit those two columns, and then I'm going to just select those two columns and copy and then paste as values only to remove our formulas, and after that I'm going to delete this original name column. And once I'm done with the steps, I'm going to click on this first cell, and that should do the steps I wanted. So I guess I also said I'm going to do some borders, so let's do that too. So I'll just select this data now, and I could have done this with a shortcut, of course, but here I'll just select it manually like this, and I'm going to go to home and add some borders, all borders. Click in this first cell and I'm done. So I'm going to go to developer, stop recording. So that created this macro. Now, the issue with this macro is that if I go to, let's say, this tab, and now try to do the same with this, which is the same type of data, except we have less rows. So if I now go to macros and try to run that same macro here, you'll see it works in a sense, but it does all of this, the formulas and these borders, for all these extra lines, because it's still going to use the original number of lines, similar to what we had in our first sheet. So if you had more than 217 lines, then it wouldn't cover the rest of these. So that's the issue we have with this macro. So let's go ahead and fix it. So I'm going to go to macros, click on this macro and hit edit to modify it. And this is that macro code that was generated when I did this. So I'm simply just going to copy all this code starting from this sub with the macro name until this end sub, which ends the macro. So just copy that. And then I'll just go to ChatGPT. And I'm going to say, update this Excel macro to get the data until the last row. I'm going to go a couple of lines down and just paste that macro code that I just generated. And I'm just going to run this. So as you can see, it did generate this new code for us. So I'll go ahead and copy this code, go back to our Excel VBA code, and simply just replace this with our new macro that was basically now updated by ChatGPT. So with this change, I'm just going to now close this macro editor, and let's just test this. So let's go to June and try to open this macros. This is that new macro, same name, run it. Great. So now that covered until this line. Let's try this again, maybe here. That seems to work just fine for this too. And now it's able to get it done until the last line. Now I want to take this a step further. So what I want to do, I want to just run this macro for all of the sheets in this file instead of going to each one and running each one separately like this. So I'm going to grab that new code. So I'll go to macros, click edit. Copy this and go back to our ChatGPT, and I'm going to ask to modify this. So I'll say update this macro to run it on every sheet in this Excel file. I'll paste the code and just simply just run this. So here's our new code. It did this for each loop, as you can see, to run this. So I'll go ahead and copy this and go back to our Excel file. And I'm going to replace this code with that new macro code. Close this editor. So now I want to run this, except that this file, I already did this on a few different sheets. So we're going to grab a fresh copy of this file, which fortunately I have because I made a copy. So let me open that fresh file. While this one open, because this one has the macro. So here's that new file. And this file is basically the original that has the name column. It's not separated and it has all the sheets. So my macro is in the other file. So I'm going to move it to this file. So I'll just go to macros. And this is that macro from the other file. I'll click edit. This is the macro. I'll copy that. Now, once I copy this, this is this macro file in this file right here, see, in modules. So this is that second file that I just opened. This is where I'm going to create this new module. So I'm going to right click, insert module. And here in this module, in the second file, I'm just going to paste that same code. So with this change, now I'm just going to close this. And now we should have that second macro. So I could just simply close the other file, which is this one. I'm going to do that. Let's close this. And this is our new file with that macro basically in it. So I'll go to macros. This is that macro. I'm going to run it. And as you can see, we got an error with this last line. I'm going to hit OK. So if I look at my data, you can see that this actually did what it had to do, but our last line had a problem with it. So let's try to fix that problem. So I'm going to go back, copy that line that had an error, and say, this line gives me an error message. Okay, so now it did update our code. I'm going to copy this and let's test this again. So what I'm going to do is close this and open a fresh version again. So there it is, a fresh copy of this. Let's try this again. So I'm going to go to developer, go to macros. There are no macros here, as you can see. So to get to that macro editor here, because there's no edit button here, I'm just going to click on this Visual Basic button on the left. It's going to get me to this macro editor. This is that new file. So I'm going to, again, right-click Insert Module. And then I just need to paste that code that I just got from ChatGPT here, which is our updated code. Close this. And now under macros, we should have this macro. I'm going to run this. Let's see what happens. Seems like we ran it just fine. Let's go ahead and check this out. Everything seems to go to the last line, including here. So that looks pretty good. So here we go. That's how we use Excel's macro recording feature combined with ChatGPT to get us very dynamic and powerful Excel macros. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.